I'm Catherine Hoffman. I'm a foreign missionary. God laid on my heart to reach as many people for Christ so they get saved and become a Christian. I'm going to tell you about reality of hell, the lake of fire. This story I'm going to tell you is about the parable of the rich man and Lazarus. Jesus said there was a certain rich man who was splendidly clothed in purple and fine linen, who lived each day in luxury. At his gate lay a poor man named Lazarus, who was covered with sores. At Lazarus lay there longing for scraps from the rich man's table. The dogs would come and lick his sores, open sores. Finally, the poor man died and was carried by angels to sit beside Abraham at the heavenly banquet. The rich man also died and was buried, and he went to the place of the dead. There in torment, he saw Abraham in the far distant with Lazarus in his sight. The rich man shouted, "Father Abraham, have some pity. Send Lazarus over here to dip the tip of my finger in water and cool my tongue. I'm in anguish, torment in these flames." But Abraham said to him, "Son, remember that during your lifetime you had everything you wanted, and Lazarus had nothing. So now he's here being comforted, and you are in an anguish. And besides, there is a great chasm separating us. No one can cross over to you, and from here, no one can cross over here to you." Then the rich man said, "Please, Father Abraham, at least send him to my father's home, for I have 5 brothers. I want them to warn them. I want you to warn them so that they won't end up in this place of torment." But Abraham said, "Moses and the prophets warned them. Your brothers can read what they wrote." The rich man replied, "No, Father Abraham, but if anyone is sent that died, then they will listen." They're going to repent of their sins and turn to God. But Abraham said, "If they won't listen to Moses and the prophets, they won't be persuaded, even if someone rises from the dead. If any one of you hear this and is not a Christian, not saved, pray this prayer. You hear about the story of Lazarus and the poor man, the rich man and Lazarus, the poor man. You hear that, and I just told you all of it, and yeah, you need to read this letter and ask Jesus to come into your heart. Jesus, come into my heart. I want, listen, if you've listened to all of this and then if you're not praying, you're not saved, pray this prayer. Jesus, come into my heart. I want you to be a part of my life. Please forgive me of all my sin. Thank you for dying for my sin on the cross. I'm asking you now to be my Savior. Jesus died for all mankind's sin. Jesus, come into my heart. I want you to be a part of my life. If you read that letter, you'll say, my name is Catherine Hoffman, and I've been here in the U.S. as since 1981. I've been serving God here in the U.S. since 1981. I want every one of you to get saved. I'm a foreign missionary, and I've been serving God since 1981. I want everyone to get saved. God laid on my heart to have a burden for people's soul. All of that I just told you, all that is about Lake of Fire, is real. If you're not a Christian, your eternal destiny is on a lake of fire that burns forever. If you are a Christian, your eternal destiny is heaven. There you can be with God and all the angels. And that's where you're going to live, in heaven. And heaven and hell is real. Your eternal destiny is determined to your decision. Your decision you make, whether you want to go to heaven or not, that makes you either go to heaven or go to the lake of fire. All of this is real. You need to listen. Ask Jesus to come into your heart now and ask him to be your Savior.